This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. We are usually bringing you stories when a star is born, but sometimes when a star dies in a fiery explosion, as is the case with Supernova, well, there are stories there to be told as well. And just recently, the journal Science published a lot of new information from Supernova 1987A. So astronomers and astrophysicists are looking up to the skies with a little bit more glee. And we are joined by one of those, Dr. Robert Kirshner from Harvard University. He is an astronomer. He is an astrophysicist. He is a professor of science. Thanks so much for being with us.
It's my pleasure.
All right, so tell us a little bit about Supernova 1987A. Now, this star's explosion happened, what, give or take 167,000 years ago, right?
Well, this is Supernova 1987A. That means we saw it. It was the first supernova, so it got the A license plate in 1987. And as you may know, that was just a few years before the space telescope was launched. So this is a supernova which is very nearby and which we've been able to study in great detail with the Hubble Space Telescope over its whole lifetime. So this is the best studied, this is the nearest, and this is the one that for which we have the best instruments to do the analysis.
Now, there was a period when the Hubble telescope wasn't doing so well, and we have managed to go and fix it. And so now you're able to compare sort of before and after pictures, right?
The early observations were a little disappointing because they were kind of blurry. But even so, for this supernova, we saw that there was the explosion itself and then a ring of stuff around it, which is material that the star lost before it exploded, maybe 20 or 30,000 years before the death of the star.
Okay, and what do you see in this ring, and how do you see this ring changing?
Well, the ring that is around the explosion is something which has been changing since we saw it in 1980, well, since we first saw it with space telescope in 1990. It's been fading away because it got excited by the light that came from the exploding star, and then it was kind of cooling off after that. But something new started to happen in 1995, which is that the material from the explosion, which is going out at about a tenth of the speed of light, the material hit the fan. And as a result, this ring started to light up. And it started to light up in very particular places, these little things we call the hot spots around the circumference of that ring. And we think that they must be stalactites that are sticking in toward the center of the explosion, because when they light up, but they stay narrow for a very long time.
So essentially we are seeing a star shooting out at incredible speeds, and we're able to watch that here from Earth.
Yes, the actual speed of the material from the exploding star itself is something like 10,000 miles a second. So, you know, roughly speaking, 30 million miles an hour. So it's moving out pretty fast. And when it collides with this stuff that was already out there, it heats it, it lights it up, and it lets us see what it's made of and how it's set up. So this is a way for us to see into the past, really, to see what that star was doing 10,000 years ago before the explosion, because that's what the ring material is made of. And the explosion itself, of course, is something which took place very rapidly. We couldn't see what was going on inside at that moment. But now, as the star expands, we get to see farther and farther in. We're getting closer to seeing what happened down in the middle of the star where the energy was generated.
All right, Dr. Robert Kirshner from Harvard University, thanks so much for joining us.